And welcome to yet another episode of Gokie's Health Talk. We've all heard that almost all diseases begin in the gut. Worst is when your doctors and anybody who is supposed to detect this are themselves not able to pinpoint the problem. And in fact, gut is now become so important. In fact, it's now famously termed as your second brain. And problems with the gut compound. Gut ke andar ki jo problems hoti hain, usse it leads to multiple other complications which are not just physical. It can also lead to anxiety and other kinds of challenges. So today I am joined by a very, very smart young lady who is working for an MNC as a business analyst. But more importantly, she was battling with this issue, which she was not even aware was caused because of a lifestyle she was leading. And today I'm happy to say that my guest Ashima has not only changed her life, but being able to completely become a different person. And this was all possible by her own efforts, by her own will, but also with working with her coach and the entire Gokie system. So without further ado, please welcome Ashima to the Gokie Health Talks.
Hi, Vishal. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for this introduction.
So great, Ashima. I'm so happy to interact with you, and especially your story is so inspirational, because in your case, you had a very unique problem which most people were unable to detect. So please tell me, how did your health problems and challenges begin? Where did it all start?
Okay. So yeah, they all started like, I was also not aware, first of all, but majorly they started around 2019 end, and you might say 2020 starting. So the thing was that I was not able to tell what is going on inside me, but definitely I was feeling like different kind of feelings, anxious, sometimes acidity, sometimes I had different other gut related issues, like I'm not able to like concentrate. And even sometimes what happened was that I was not able to concentrate on my office work as well. So it was like all mixed feelings, and yet I was not able to tell what was the issue was me. And even doctors, they were also not able to tell. So I consulted like around 10 to 15 doctors. Different doctors.
10 and to 15 thing doctor. Was 15 doctors.
Yeah, even exactly. So even I have all the prescriptions with me. And the thing
what were you telling these doctors? Because you know you were going to doctor number one, doctor number two. So matlab, what was happening? What were you describing your symptoms to the doctor? What did they test in you?
Okay, so I was describing like I am having stomach pain, I am having acidity, I was describing I am having like trembling, jhanjhanahat jisko aap kehte hain, haath ki, pair ki, right? I was having shivering sometimes, like sudden cold, sudden like that feelings, mixed feelings. But so in the starting, doctor said that you have stomach infection. So it was like I took 6 times stomach infections medicines, consulting to 5 to 6 doctors, and nothing happened. It was just like
basically they say, "Arey kuch nahi pet kharab."
Exactly, pet kharab hai.
And I was like, "You must have eaten something, bad, etc." So yeah, just take this.
Exactly. So it was like, take these medicines. I was like, isse kuch nahi ho raha. And I told them, isse kuch nahi ho raha. So they extended, okay, take the extended version of it. I was like, tabhi bhi kuch nahi ho raha. And then it started actually, isse aur bura hone laga. Like I was not able. So when I got up in the morning, bahut zyada bloating. you understand, it was like I woke up and it's all like gas ban rahi hai, acidity ho rahi hai, and all those problems. And it was on my head, you know, when you have something gastric inside you, wo head pe jaake, and it is like paining shoulders, paining everywhere, because obviously it's gas, right? So then doctor suggested, okay, go for Pandi, you have those gastric medicines, right? Some detected it is GERD issue. I also had refluxes, right? So that is why I think they detected, okay, you have the GERD issue. I was like, okay, I'll take those medicines. Then another doctor, IBS, you know what is IBS? It's like Bowel syndrome, right? So I was taking, then that was the, I think, second last or last doctor who was telling, okay, you have IBS. We don't have any solution for this. You have to take medicines. And actually they gave me sleeping medicine, anxiety medicine, and I guess some of the stomach related medicines. Wow. Jo aapka pachane mein help karta hai.
Ashima, what you
and it was like,
and kitna time ye, kitne mahine se ye chal raha tha?
So when I started taking medicines, it was end of 2019. I started taking medicines. Chalte, it was like starting 2020, April, May, June, it was there.
4-5-6 mahine tak you were seeing different doctors. Different doctors were telling you ki ye GERD hai, ye IBS hai, ye pet kharab hai, ye hai, ye wo hai, neem ki goli khao.
Right.
And what was, I mean, I'm sure your, you know, your friends, your parents, your family members must be really, really concerned ki ye ho kya raha hai Ashima ko.
They were concerned. I went for full body test, even for ultrasound, just to check ke kuch aisa to nahi hai, like life threatening, ya fir they were sure ki aisa kuch life threatening nahi hai, but again they suggested, okay, go for full body checkup, check what's wrong with you. Family members were like, kuch nahi hai, ho jayega theek with time, it's just because your digestion is not correct, etc. But yeah, they were concerned. That's why we went from 10 to 15 doctors.
I'll tell you something again. I know this is a different question. I'm sure you must have also googled your symptoms, right? Aapne kabhi to Google mein dala hoga, iska matlab kya hai ye sab?
I would say never Google. Okay, Google karne pe it's like extreme case. And definitely, maine Google kiya. Usse kuch nahi hua. Anxiety badh gayi meri. Never Google. I would say.
See, the biggest problem of your condition was not the condition itself, but kisi ko pata nahi ye kya hai. So that is more concerning, right? That
right.
Detect nahi kar pa raha hai. And you know, our human brain, right? Are ye koi cancer to nahi, ye to kuch ye nahi, ye koi tumor nahi. I mean, you know, aajkal kya kya sunne ko aata hai, right? So it is really, I mean, I can only imagine your situation. So tell me, after 15 doctors could not detect it, how did you end up using Goki? Matlab ye kahan se ghum ke yahan kaise aa gaya?
So it was not the first choice. Matlab I would tell you frankly, one of my family doctor recommended ke at least apni diet and fitness pe thoda dhyan do, maybe ye sab cheeze, it will go eventually. I did not install it for 1 month. I was not sure. I was like, doctors are not able to do it, so what to do? I was like, not sure. Then again I was reminded that, okay, one of my friend reminded ki, okay, you have that Goki application, right? I was like, I haven't signed in, main sign in karke dekh leti hu, and I did. So I created my profile around March 2020. So then I started my journey, and I was actually offered some coupon with the free coach, 3 months free coaching, and that was my coach Meenakshi. And yes, then I started my journey with Goki.
But you know, you must be skeptical. Hai, 15 doctor kuch nahi kar paaye. Ye kya, you know, Goki with you know, koi coach. Matlab, you know, what was your thought process? You know, because you must be very dejected overall, right? Ki kya ho raha hai? So, what was your thought process when you started your journey?
Frankly telling, I was not taking it seriously in the starting. I was like, theek hai, along with medicines. So medicines were already there. I did not stop medicines till then, and it was there. But I started Goki gradually, did not take it seriously in the starting. However, I was too much attracted towards the habits which were actually given to me. So it was like, you have 15 days, try these habits for 15 days. And they were like starting simple. So I was like, okay, let's take it as a challenge. Why not? Although I did not feel like doing anything at that point of time, but I was like, okay, let's push and let's try to do this. Agar main ye nahi kar sakti, toh fir, how will I do other things in my life? So that is where I pushed myself, and okay, I started adding food logs, water logs, and simple habits which were provided in the starting.
And tell me something, what is your background? Did you do like commerce? What did you study? How did you get this strength, right? Because, you know, anybody else would have, you know, after 15 doctors would have just given up and said, oh God, mera pata nahi kya hoga, you get yourself admitted in the hospital. So where did this strength come from?
Right. Actually, strength, you might say that I was like, abhi meri age hi kya hai, right? Abhi is age pe, what is the point giving up? So that was always in my mind. Ki, I'm just 27, right? So it's not an age jahan par aap give up kar do and you start. So definitely, us time jo thinking process thi, because of all those anxiety, depression, it's kind of losing hope at that time.
And then lockdown started, right? And again, usi ke dauran COVID aa gaya, right? All this happened during that time only, right?
Exactly, right, at that time only. So I was like, my family was with me and they were like, we cannot see you like this, and we want like how you were 1 year before or 2 years before, we want that particular Ashima. Ye nahi chalega. And that is where, okay, I thought ke yaar ye to galat ho raha hai. Matlab, I was not like this. Matlab, side mein lete rehna, uthne paana, and किसी से बात करने का मन नहीं है, बाहर जाने का मन नहीं है. सो ये सारी चीजें मैं नहीं हूँ ऐसी. एंड उस टाइम इट वॉज लाइक दैट ओनली, कि बाहर जा रहे हैं तो एनजाइटी अटैक आ रहा है. आई एम नॉट एबल टू इवन गो अ लिटिल आउट, लाइक पास में पार्क है वहां भी नहीं जा पा रहे हो. तो एंड आई यूजली, मतलब मैं ट्रैवल को बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस देती हूँ. आई लाइक टू ट्रैवल अ लॉट. सो मेरे लिए तो ये एक शॉकिंग चीज थी कि ये कैसे हो रहा है. आई एम नॉट इवन doing these things, so kaise chalega aage?
You know, it is very interesting that acidity is one of the most common conditions in India. Har aadmi ko acidity hai, har ghar mein kisi na kisi ko acidity hai. Aur acidity ke liye koi log bolte hai, are wo koi antacid le lo, ye le lo, wo le lo. In fact, a lot of people even mistake heart related issues as acidity. Logo ko heart attack ho raha hai to ye bolte hai acidity ho rahi hai. तो ये एसिडिटी से चालू होके इतना कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हेल्थ कंडीशन कैसे हो गया?
सो एंड यू आर राइट, एक्चुअली एसिडिटी का ना हार्ट कंडीशन से लिंक लोग बिठा ले. मैंने खुद बिठाया था, आई वोंट लाई. मैंने खुद सोचा था कि इट्स समथिंग आई शुड गेट ईसीजी डन, इको डन. मैंने सब कुछ सर्च कर रखा था कि क्या करना है क्या नहीं करना है. सो कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशन ऐसे हो गया, लाइक एसिडिटी इज वन थिंग. देन व्हाट हैपेंस कि आप खा नहीं सकते एसिडिटी में, यू डोंट फील लाइक ईटिंग, एंड यू स्टार्ट टू लाइक लूज वेट इन सम केसेस. एंड मेरे केस में लूज वेट हुआ था, एंड लो इन एनर्जी, एंड अगेन स्टमक इश्यूज, पेन इन स्टमक. एंड ऑल सो सोच सोच के इट वॉज लाइक ट्रिगरिंग टू माई हेड. एंड उससे और कॉम्प्लेक्स हो गई सिचुएशन. लाइक माय पल्पिट्रेशंस वर हाई, देन आई वाज हैविंग द ट्रेम्बलिंग इफेक्ट एज आई टोल्ड यू, एंड आई वाज लाइक आई कैन नॉट एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेन दैट कंडीशन, बट इट इज ऑल रिलेटेड टू दोज डिप्रेशन एंड एंजाइटी फेज आई वुड से. सो एवरीथिंग, या सो that was the end point where everything was so complicated. So it was not just my stomach, it was everything. I felt like, okay, I don't know, heart problem hai, I don't know kya problem hai. So it was all so much messed up.
So I know at that time you had somebody enter your life who may help you make this important change. And right now, before we continue this conversation ahead, I'm actually going to invite your coach, Meenakshi, who is just about to join us for the session. Welcome, Meenakshi. Welcome to the Gokie Health Talks. Are you here? Meenakshi, you are in mute, I think. Yeah, we can see you now. Hi.
Hello, sir. Hi, Ashima.
Hi, Meenakshi.
Hello, Meenakshi. How are you?
Good Hello, to sir. See your name. Thank you so much, sir.
And now this is our second session with Meenakshi. We also recently had one of our other players, Nirmal, who had a fantastic show with us. So it is good to see Meenakshi back here, but now with her second most favorite player or first most favorite. I don't know whether you are first or second, but I wanted to have Meenakshi here. So Meenakshi, now you tell me what was happening when you onboarded or when you got Ashima onto Gokie. This is a complex situation. 15 doctor log detect nahi kar paye ki ho kya raha hai. How did you find out what's wrong with her and how did you help her get over this problem?
Yes, sir. So when she came on board, she was very nervous. So actually she has two issues, GERD and anxiety. So I was also confused which is affecting, anxiety or GERD. So basically it was related to her gut health. So she was having acidity issue and more acidity in morning, anxiety related to gut health. She was more conscious about gut health. So because of gut health, she was facing anxiety issue. So I asked her all her details regarding what was the issue. She told me everything. It took around 40 to 45 minutes for our intro call.
Mm-hmm.
Then I get to know, like, first I have to work upon her acidity issue, gut health. So we started slowly, like she was not having meals early morning. She was having long gap between meals. And so I started with very few basic habits.
But my question is something more basic, right? So when she created a Gokie account and came on board, what helped you figure all this out from her profile? Because, you know, a lot of people don't fill out all the information or they don't even say about all these issues. So how did you get all this information? And I think for some reason we have lost Ashima. So she might be joining us, I guess. I think her connection got lost or something. So hopefully she'll be back. But why don't you continue telling us about how did you detect or first diagnose the problem?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually she was facing more anxiety issue. So I was like very confused why she is getting that anxiety issue. So slowly when I get to know about her daily routine, so she feels anxiety because of her gut health. She was very concerned about her health. Why I'm facing that acidity issue, dizziness, stomach upset. So after that, like she told me, like morning she is skipping meals, then she is having long gap between meals. She is eating very fast. So I thought, let's start with very small few basic habits. So slowly, like that we started.
So by just looking at her diet pattern and her daily habits, that's why while we lost you, you know, Meenakshi was explaining to us how did she diagnose your problem. And the best part about diagnosing your problem was she was observing your daily routine. And your daily routine played a big role. So she was just telling us about some gaps in your routine. So tell me, first of all, how comfortable were you to talk to a stranger, right? I mean, you have not met, you know, when you started Gokie, you had no idea who Meenakshi is. And, you know, suddenly koi aapko ye sab sawal pooch raha hai, aap app mein baat kar rahe ho. So how were you so comfortable to share all this information with Meenakshi?
So initially, I was not that comfortable, but actually she made things comfortable. So she started like, what is your journey? What is your history? And she actually, the way she talks and the way she advised things as well as added my habits, it was like somebody very close talking to me, understanding my issues. And in every, like, we have those calls every 15 days. So in every 15 days, writing out notes, what is the problem? How can we work on it? It was very personal. So I connected on that level. So it is like, I share many things with her about my health, and she is always there to answer everything. So she is now part of my life. I am not able to leave her.
No, I think Meenakshi is so amazing that, you know, she's become part of your life. But one very important aspect which you just touched upon here, right, that you were very comfortable talking to her. So tell me, you met 15 doctors. Why were you not comfortable on talking about all these issues to the doctor? How was it different than interacting with the doctor?
So with the doctors, it's like, we have limited time, right? When we visit, it's like you can talk to them in that time and they will prescribe something and we'll go back home. That's it. But with Meenakshi, it's like I can chat with her anytime, right? Anytime I feel anything or any habit I want to change or any improvement I want, I can talk to her anytime. Especially we have those calls after every 15 days, I told you, then we can talk more in detail. So it's not possible with doctors.
Got it. So Meenakshi se sirf 15 din apne call kiya to iske wajah se ho gaya ki Meenakshi, how was she as a player? Because I know you have many players, but tell me seriously, was Ashima really following what you told her?
Yes, sir. She started following like lemon water. I said initially she was neglecting this thing. I will feel like more acidity I will feel if I drink lemon water. Slowly she tried, and now she is more comfortable. She is drinking daily, every day, lemon, ginger water, everything. She drinks a lot and she is very consistently following the all habits.
Wow. So she first thought ki lemon water se aur acidity bhaiya, because lemon is citric, right? So you think, are acid to wo acid hai, right? So tell me, right, how would lemon water treating acidity, because most people think ki lemon is citric acid. So how can citric acid cure acidity? Ye kya hai? Kaise bata sakte hai? Tell us.
Actually, lemon makes our body alkaline. Lemon itself is acidic, but lemon makes our body alkaline. So it helps to digest the food easily also. So before food, means if you have lemon water, definitely it will help to control acidity, bloating, any kind of gut health issue also.
And tell me something, why is gut so confused? I mean, why are people not able to figure out, and how is gut connected to anxiety and mental health and depression? Matlab, ye dono ka connection kisi ko samajh hi nahi aa raha, right? I mean,
yes. Like, if she feels anxiety because of gut health, because when she gets anxiety attack, she feels numbness in hands and legs. There was dizziness, more acid in her esophagus. So because of that, like, if your gut health is not good, definitely it will increase your anxiety levels also. If you're more anxiety, means there is no proper secretion of enzymes of gut health. So food will be not digest properly, assimilate, absorption of nutrients also not happens. You will feel more bloating and gas also. So both are interrelated actually.
So Ashima, tell me, Meenakshi aapko ye sab bata rahi thi, you were really following all these things, and what were your gharwale thinking ki kya ho gaya, Ashima suddenly is having nimbu and ginger and all these? I am sure your grandmother or grandfather or somebody in your family would have also told you, tabhi aapne kuch nahi kiya
hoga. Right, exactly. So that is what happened. Initially, I was like reluctant. I was not following anything, not anything, but yeah, little bit, not actually that much sure that it will work. And yes, I started. And yes, my grandmother told me that जब हमने बोला तब तुमने नहीं सुना, अभी मीनाक्षी बोल रही है तो तुम सुन रहे हो. सो आई एम लाइक ओके, लेट मी ट्राई, क्योंकि घर वालों का तो यू नो, राइट? सो एग्जैक्टली दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंड. And that is what my father was also telling, ki apne lifestyle change karo. He used to say, but with this application, I was changing my lifestyle. And then again, he was saying, jab maine bola tha, tab tumne nahi mana. I was like, okay.
Coach bol raha hai, toh aap sab kar rahe ho. That is interesting. Huh?
Yeah, that is interesting. So, yeah, but definitely. Initially, mujhe thoda problem aaya thi. Talking to Meenakshi and actually surety, that's why हमारा lemon water पे ही इतना बड़ा discussion चला था कि वो acidic है and how can it will reduce my acidity. But eventually वो started, you see the differences, right? तो वो difference दिखने जब start होते हैं, then you stop questioning and you start following, right? So that is what happened.
So when did you start seeing the difference and finally what was the difference?
So differences were like धीरे धीरे, not एकदम से. Even 1 or 2 weeks आपको कुछ फर्क भी नहीं पता चलेगा. Like it's like same condition and same acidity etc. But धीरे धीरे it was like 3 weeks, 4 weeks. I started feeling better and I started like feeling less anxious. Not actually totally coped up, but ऐसा था कि attacks कम थे. And anxious kam thi and it was like finally mujhe khana khane ka man thoda thoda kar raha tha. Pehle bilkul nahi karta tha, but when I changed these things so fir then I started consuming things. So wo dheere dheere pata chala, it was not ekdam se, and it took around 6 to 7 months total to cope up that situation.
That's wow, 6 to 7 months, huh? That's a long time, but kudos to you. Eh? You were like very seriously following it, because a lot of times people, you know, to koi cheez do teen hafte karte hain, fir chhod dete hain. You know, people do things, but they then not sustain it. How did you sustain this for so long?
So, wo simple si saying hai, when you start seeing improvements, aap wo chhod nahi paate. And when you develop the habit, कोई भी एक हैबिट जो आपको अच्छी लगती है, यू कैन नॉट लीव इट. तो अब जैसे आई स्टार्टेड कंज्यूमिंग फ्रूट्स ऑन डेली बेसिस या सैलड्स, आई लाइक इट, मुझे इतने ज्यादा पसंद आए. आई एम स्टिल, मीनाक्षी विल टेल यू, आई सेंड हर प्लैटर्स डेली, लाइक आई एम ईटिंग दिस, आई एम ईटिंग दैट. तो जो चीज आपको अच्छी लगती
है, योर फूड लॉग्स आल्सो.
या या
नो
सर, यस
मीना
sir, if you'll see in Gokhi Arena fruit logs, no one can beat her Ashima's fruit logs. She is so colorful and so healthy fruits.
Amazing. No, Ashima, I think, you know, it's really amazing how you have adopted Gokhi and the Gokhi life. And overall, see, you are the best example of change of lifestyle. See, normally, log kya bolte hain, arre, maine 5 kilo wazan lose kar liya, maine ye kar liya, maine wo kar liya. What you have done is so much more bigger, right? Because you are dealing with a challenge of serious health. Nobody could find out problem kya hai, and this was compounding into mental health, it was compounding into so many other things, right? So I mean, what you have done is truly remarkable. So tell me, ye jab transition aap ye jab kar rahi thi journey, what was the reaction of your friends and office colleagues and others ki ye ho kya raha hai, ki family wala ko to pata chal gaya aap app mein kuch kar rahe ho. What were these other people thinking?
So I would tell you, शुरू में दे वर लाइक, व्हाट आर यू सेंडिंग दी स्क्रीनशॉट्स फॉर एंड व्हाट आर यू टेकिंग दिस पिक्चर्स फॉर, बिकॉज आई यूज टू शेयर एवरी डाइट और एवरी फूड आई एम हैविंग इवन इन ऑफिस. सो दे वर लाइक, क्या चल रहा है ये. एंड इनिशियली आई वुड टेल यू, दे वर लाइक, जब मेरा स्टार्टिंग का फेज था, कि तुझे क्या हो गया है, व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू यू, यू आर लाइक, तुम्हारा वेट इतना रिड्यूस हो गया है. एंड दे न्यू दैट मुझे प्रॉब्लम्स है बहुत सारी. एंड ग्रेजुअली विद टाइम, अभी सो लॉकडाउन लग गया, आई डिड नॉट गेट टू इंटरेक्ट विद देम. अभी विद ऑफिस ओपनिंग, आई वेंट टू ऑफिस 1 or 2 days एंड देवर लाइक, ये ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन तो आशिमा ने किया है और किसी ने नहीं किया इतना अच्छा ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. सो देवर लाइक टेलिंग मी कि तूने क्या किया, व्हाट डिड यू डू, व्हाट डिड यू फॉलो. एंड फॉर एवरीवन आई वाज सेइंग दैट, you know, install this, but वो serious नहीं होता ना कोई पहली बार में करना कैसे है, right? So they were like shocked. This time they met me and they are shocked that what has happened to you. You were like this and now suddenly you are a new person all the way. So
how do you describe Gokhi to your friends and whoever asks you कि Gokhi क्या है? सबको तो लगता है Gokhi एक band है, fitness band है. But what do you
exactly
tell them, ye kya hai?
Exactly. So they are like, ye to fitness band hai. What are you doing with that? I'm like, nahi. So I explain with the application only. I tell them ki dekho, I have a personal coach. I have certain habits. I have different articles I can go through. I have challenges. I have life sessions. So then they take interest. Okay, kya kya sessions hai yahan par, and what are the habits? Kyunki ab now they have seen the difference. So they are more interested in ke, how did you do it? And that is where I tell them ke, it's not about just 1 month or so, but you have to actually start. When you actually enroll, you'll see, you'll be assigned a coach and you'll see what she or he will tell you, that how to follow that and what is good for you, what is your goal specifically. So they work according to kya aapka goal hai, right?
So one very interesting thing you talked about is goal. A lot of times, you know, ki ye pucha hi nahi jata hai, aapke doctor ke paas jata hai, ye pucha hi jata hai, goal kya hai? Wo to aapko puch rahe hai, aapka symptom batao, main aapko ek dawai dunga. But you know, I want to tell you something. At Gokey, we have a very interesting approach. So we actually have doctors also on board of Gokey. I don't know if you have done a Gokey doctor consultation yet, but there is an entire focus, because we don't believe that healthcare and Gokey is different. We are the future of healthcare. So what we do is we integrate doctors, coaches, everything together. So now what I want to do is actually invite one of our doctors, Dr. Viral, who has just joined us, because gut related issues are massive. And I want to ask Dr. Viral. Dr. Viral, are you here? Yes, Dr. Viral is here. Welcome, doctor. So I had a question for you. You know, Ashima here went to 15 doctors, not one, not two, 15, but not even one was able to diagnose and treat her condition. While at Gokey, our coaches were successfully able to do it. So what is missing right now in this system, and how does the Gokey approach work? I mean, given you are yourself a medical practitioner.
Okay, so hello Ashima, I'm glad to be the 16th one, so you can listen to a 16th fellow. Anyways, see Vishal, the thing is, as you rightly pointed out, a person might not have Aadhaar card, but the person will have acidity. It's that common. So
that's a very good quote.
Yeah,
so, acidity
so everyone would have experienced, right from as a child you have burping things till the, as you keep on growing, acid, and it's so I will come to a point, I just have to give a background on that. It's where acid is considered as a villain actually by the people, but you don't know it's a blessing. Without that, your food won't be divided into the components where, you know, the body needs it. So the only thing is mismanagement of that leads to the issue. Now, what is lacking is, I think more than a band, as you rightly pointed out, it's a review system, I would say. The Gokey, it's a review system where a person, someone is there with a stick on your head, maybe politely, of course, not as a stick, that what you have done today, and gradually you adapt that lifestyle. So I think, as Ashima rightly said, the time given by a doctor these days, if you go to a hardcore gastroenterologist or maybe a doctor, say a general practitioner, they see only, when you say acidity, only gut as the symptom, or gut, they don't see Ashima. They will see Ashima's gut. But Ashima is made up of a lot more things than gut. So probably in-depth history taking, what we say, as we label as, is very much important, that who is Ashima, how she has approached towards the family, towards the work, the attitude towards work. I think Ashima has already been gone through that health entire question and answer session. There itself, when we have those question and answer session ready, when I am taking a call for the player, I already know a little bit background of Ashima more than Ashima's gut. So I think the missing link here is not treating Ashima and treating Ashima's acidity. What Meenakshi was able to do was understand Ashima. And once whatever the loopholes were there, they were automatically, the symptoms started disappearing. So that is where I think where we, as an integrative approach and a team, maybe you are the right now, you have started this, in future there will be 3-4 doctors sitting as a viva, you know, the way you give exams, viva, that someone is talking about the mental health, emotional health, and then physical health. that can be one of the future, but I'm glad Ashima could at least come to the right place after 15 doctors, and you are fixing thing. And I think your history, I've gone through to that, and 95% things have been fixed. So I'm glad it's 5% is pending. So you tend to learn more about yourself. So I think, yeah, this is what we need to work on. Maybe give more time towards patient, and even patient has to, as Ashima rightly said in the beginning, she don't Google many things. Otherwise, Ashima would have come with a diagnosis rather than symptoms. So that is again a loophole where nowadays patient come with a diagnosis rather than telling what and how it happened. So yeah, I think giving more time and going in depth, understanding how Ashima is a personality, if we can pick up that, any symptoms can be fixed.
Amazing. I think what you just talked about, Dr. Viral, is so important, right? That everybody was only treating Ashima's gut. Nobody was treating Ashima the person.
Yeah.
And I think that is part of the challenge of healthcare, right? Healthcare is वो बोलते हैं ना हाथी को किसी ने पूंछ को पकड़ा हुआ है, किसी ने उसकी ट्रंक को पकड़ा हुआ है, किसी ने उसके पैर को पकड़ा हुआ है, and all the blind people are trying to imagining the elephant. So that is the fundamental problem. But the other big elephant in the room, by the way, is mental health. And we know during the lockdown, there has been such big challenges around mental health. We also did a study at Gokhi around it. We have also seen that how disease manifests into mental issues. You know, people with diabetes, people with chronic illness. In fact, people who even have people who are sick at home. A lot of people get into problems when they have parents who are sick or family members who are sick. So to address that, I am now inviting one other very important person to this discussion. She is one of the most sought out mental well-being coach. In fact, she does a lot of sessions, and I know Ashima must have seen any of her shows on Gokhi Play. We right now have Divya Thampi joining us on this live. Divya, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
So Divya, here is a real example of somebody with a young person with an underlying condition which manifested into so many mental and physical issues. And we heard the beautiful story of Ashima on how the Gokhi team was able to help her. So could you first of all kind of give us some sense of how all this got connected to anxiety and depression? I mean, it's very difficult to make this connect.
So first of all, you know, your story has been very inspiring, Ashima. Yeah. And it's been lovely listening to each person making those connections. And yeah, Vishal, you're so right that the current environment of the COVID, as it is actually generating anxiety in all of us. I don't think any of us have escaped those feelings of anxiety, increased levels of anxiety. And, you know, one of the basic things that happens is anxiety is a good thing. You know, just like Dr. Viral was talking about how acid is a good thing. Anxiety is a good thing. It's like any other emotion. We need anxiety because it directs our attention towards something which is dangerous or threatening for our well-being. Right? Now, what happens is when your attention, so we get into a fight or flight mode whenever we feel that there is some kind of a threat, and the body starts, and this happens because the body starts releasing stress hormones.
That's cortisol, right? Cortisol.
And when it does that, what the body does is it will, all the resources are directed towards taking care of the immediate situation, as a result of which it will shut down the other activities in the background. Which is your, you know, so the gut health and your digestion and reproductive activities, all of those take a backseat. And that is also a reason why anxiety automatically has an impact on, you know, your immunity dips, because the body is not focusing on immunity anymore. It is kind of focusing on dealing with the situation. The other thing that happens with anxiety is that after you get into a stress of muscles, sweating, your palpitation of the heart and all of that, it takes a few hours, even after that threat is gone, for the body to come back to like a relaxed state, right? But if you are consistently having anxiety triggers, right? So you're worrying about, oh, will something happen to me or my family members? When are things going to be better? Then it's like, you know, wire tripping. बार बार वही हो रहा है कि मतलब आपका बार बार ट्रिगर आ रहा है तो बार बार एंजाइटी वापस आ रहा है तो आपको उस लूप में से निकलना थोड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है different. So even, you know, depression and anxiety, a lot of people think that these happen to people who are mentally weak and you should be strong. But that's not true. Actually, depression and anxiety is a coping mechanism. You know, anxiety disorders and depression, they are coping mechanisms. Like when the situation seems so hopeless, our body starts to kind of shut down. Our mind wants to shut down to give it a little bit of a rest from the stress. Right. So what Ashima did was, so the fact that she reached out and she got into this environment, you know. So one was she herself deciding and setting that goal, like Vishal, you were describing. Second is, you know, getting into this environment where she had an accountability partner. There were habits which actually were being tracked on a regular basis. There were people who were, you know, she said that she was watching videos or reading articles. So there is this entire environment which is focused on staying healthy. And that's a big factor. In fact, even for purely issues of depression and anxiety, a lot of people think, yeah, dawa khalo, pop some pills and get better. But actually, mental health is, you know, it's a, you have to look at it holistically, just like Dr. Viral spoke about physical health. It has to be looked at holistically.
So Ashima, tell me, what was the most difficult part of your journey? And how did you finally overcome that? There must be moments where you wanted to give up and said, forget it, ye sab kuch nahi ho raha.
Yes, yes, definitely. So most difficult part was that only, jab aapko aisa lagta hai ki nothing is happening, and when people say ki it can turn into clinical depression case, and people, when I say people, I would say that therapists and doctors, they say it like this, and it's like hopeless. And जो वो डर होता है ना अंदर, दैट पर्टिकुलर, जब आप अंदर से ही सोचने लगते हो कि अब कुछ नहीं हो सकता, एंड सब कुछ ट्राई कर लिया है, अब आई हैव टू लिव लाइक दिस, दैट वॉज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन. और आई वुड से जो मेड अप इन माई हेड था ये सब चीजें, कि अब मैं बाहर नहीं निकल पाऊंगी, तो ये सबसे डिफिकल्ट था मेरे लिए, कि मैंने ये सोचा. और आई वुड हैव लाइक, मतलब मेरा था कि अब क्या होगा, आई डोंट नो. सो दैट वॉज द most difficult thing.
And Meenakshi, how did you help her cope with these scenarios, right? Because you are monitoring her, talking to her on a weekly, two weekly basis, you were chatting with her. So how did you figure out ki ye sab problems ho rahi hai? Because you are sitting remotely, right? You have no idea ki kya ho raha hai. You are just having some phone calls and reading some text messages.
Actually, sir, we were discussing in our calls, follow-up calls, review calls, everything. She discussed with me each everything, her, what was the moment, why she got anxiety because of this thing, that thing. She faced many issues, we can't say, but she faced everything, bad thoughts, any bad news, everything she faced. So slowly, slowly we try like meditation, deep breathing before sleep and when you wake up. So she is trying and she cope up with that.
You don't just say so easily, are meditation, deep breathing, like these are very difficult things to do for normal people. How did you do all this?
Sir, daily
everybody do meditation, but actually meditation karna itna aasan nahi hai.
No, daily I have to remind her. Daily I was keeps messaging her, do try deep breathing, do try meditation, and she keeps following the meditations basically.
So tell me, something has really meditation helped you? And Divya, how is meditation, deep breathing connected with mental health, right? What is there some deep connection? How does this whole thing work?
Yeah, so thank you for asking that question. Actually, they are very closely related in the fact that when you do deep breathing, it starts off the relaxation response, because the vein that goes from the heart gets activated, you know. So deep breathing as well as meditation have a direct impact on relaxation response. So earlier I was talking about how you get into a stress response and it's very difficult to move back into a relaxation response. So when you consciously do deep breathing and practice meditation on a regular basis, you are consciously helping the body to go back into a relaxation response. So it helps in the short run also, and it helps in the long run as well. It's giving you that break from the constant sense of...
And Ashima, tell me, how easy or difficult was it for you to do meditation and deep breathing? Because like, it's easier said than done, right? And how did you figure out how to do all these things.
So definitely Meenakshi shared few of the videos like how to start meditation for beginners. It was not like I had in mind that how to do it. So I started with that. Also with meditation, few of the yoga postures and all the yoga asanas, I would say. So keeping the camera like this, or I would say YouTube video like this, trying to do it, like how it can be done. Also, there was a link in, I think, Goki also, where it was like how to perform certain kind of postures or meditation. I have actually seen those also in that time. So it was not easy, definitely not easy. It's like waking up every day and taking out 30 minutes every day to concentrate, listening to the things and just focusing on one thing. So it's actually not easy, but definitely if you go through few of the basics, you can at least start with the basics and it will develop gradually.
And tell me something now, how are your gut issues and how is your overall well-being right now compared to when you started?
I don't have any gut issues now. I can say it proudly. I am all okay. No gut issues.
That deserves a big round of applause to you and Meenakshi and the entire team. This is amazing. From 15 doctors, and now you are saying I have no issues. That's amazing. I think her network is gone. But anyway, so Dr. Meeral, I want to come to you. Oh, she's back. Ashima.
Sorry. Yeah, I'm back.
Yeah, Ashima, please go ahead. I think she still has a network issue. So I think while Ashima comes back, Dr. Veeral, tell me something that, you know, I'm sure aise bahut lakhon mein cases honge, right? Acidity and all these things complicated. At Goki, why do you think our approach has been so effective in getting these things back into track?
I think more it's kind of a holistic thing. As I mentioned in the past conversation that, you know, it is, they focus on only on the symptom. But honestly speaking, there is nothing like disease. Whatever symptoms are coming, our body's feedback. If there is some acidity, it's a feedback of your body. Body is trying to communicating, because she's communicating something, that something is going wrong. They are all alert mechanisms. And gradually, if you don't listen, they will keep on increasing the severity. So I think Goki, as I told you, it's a review system where it picks up all the aspects, all the dimension, where physical symptom is definitely one of the, because I think most of the people join because of the physical symptoms. But here you catch people, and I mean, I'm talking very raw, but that is how it happens. You catch people, you pick up their personality, you pick up their mental patterns, I would say, more than mental health. You pick up the mental patterns, you pick up the emotional, whatever clinging or impressions which has happened, and you start diagnosing where exactly is the root cause. So even one thing has been addressed, automatically you will see there is decrease in the symptoms, and that what positive vicious cycle starts there. Okay, something is fixed, something physically is fixed, that person gets conviction, and that conviction itself gives you good hormones. As Divya was telling, it will release good hormones of success. Okay, something is better. And that motivates a person to go ahead and implement things in a better way. And if this consistently is maintained, and we have people like Meenakshi who keeps on, you know, kahan clutch dabana hai, kahan gear lagana hai, aur kahan pe speed karna hai. That is how, you know, they are more kind of a motorcycles here, you know, and wherever servicing is required, you come other people into play. And that is where the entire car is managed rather than just looking at the petrol tank. That is where I feel. So I was just trying to give an analogy through it. And that is where we have been successful and people have given so beautiful results.
So I think I have one question for you, Divya. As you know, there is always a taboo around mental health and mental well-being in this country. But today, it is so beautiful that we are discussing it so openly, but not in a negative way. We are discussing it because it didn't manifest. It manifested from a gut-related issue. It was nothing to do with, you know, really any real serious mental issue. So what is your view on cases like this, and are people getting misdiagnosed? Because this could have, imagine if some doctor would have said, "Arey, ye to clinical depression," and she would have gone into antidepressants and that would have caused another set of problems, right? So this kind of cases would have become worse had it gone to the antidepressant route, and that would have caused even more health problems to her.
So you've kind of hit the nail on the head, and this is a problem that we face. So one of the good things about COVID, like you said, is that it has brought the mental health to the limelight in a good way, because everybody is dealing with it. It cannot be ignored anymore. And in fact, if this is what happens with a lot of us, that we deal with something which looks like depressive symptoms. So we go to a doctor, and like Dr. Viral said, you know, normally there is a medical approach to the situation. Oh, these are the symptoms. Okay, let's do a diagnosis. You have depression. This is the medication, right? And nothing else is being done. So, but what the person needs is an environment where they can actually, you know, somebody who's there to nurture them, to guide them, to hold them accountable, to encourage them, you know, advise them on all the other aspects of their life. So, in fact, there is a book called Lost Connections, which is by a chap who himself suffered from depression for like 18, 19 years. And he says that a depression medication works for a maximum of 8 weeks at a stretch. After that, so that's why people have to keep increasing the dose after that. Yeah. And most people who get into the depression medication have a lot of difficulty getting off it. And doctors don't encourage it. They're like, okay, you are on medication. You better keep it like that, because if I take you off medication, you will go back into this. And a lot of people who eventually do come out are people who somehow fortunately find environments like this where they have a proper support system, which is holistic.
Wow, that's so important what you just said, right? That if diagnostics is also single dimensional, it can cause a lot of problems. People need to look at all dimensions, which is what, you know, Meenakshi here did. So now, Meenakshi, you have got such excellent results for Ashima. What are her next goals? Where are you taking her next in her health journey?
After anxiety and that acidity health goal, we completed that health goal. Now we have completed one more health goal, that was to improve her fitness level. Now we are working on to gain weight. So she was 50 kg, now she is 51.9 kg.
Wow.
52. Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. So you are now already moved up the goal, and now you are working on the fitness goal. And that's the beauty of this, right? It is not, again, a one-way street that ek ho gaya to khatam, right? This is a lifelong engagement of health. And I'm so happy that you're already defining more and more goals for Ashima. Ashima is so young. She's just 27, even though she just looks 24. 22, but and she's also looking younger by the day with all the stuff Meenakshi is doing. So Ashima, what is your message to people who are listening to you? Because the issues you are going through, I can tell you millions of people are having these issues. It is not unique to you. What is your message to your friends, colleagues, and people listening to this, especially pertaining to health?
Right. So before starting that, I would like to say that, as I told you, I'm not able to leave Meenakshi. So that's why I started again with another goal. So that's the first thing. I'm not able to leave her. In fact, Goki. So the message to all people would be that try to basically trust on what we are saying. Like I am also saying that, yes, you can actually go with Goki and try to check all the habits and change your lifestyle basically with Goki. So most of the people don't know how to change the lifestyle. When we say change the lifestyle, people don't understand what is it. Lifestyle mein kya change karna hai. Lekin at least in this platform, we have something where we can actually start working towards that goal. And by changing lifestyle, I think you can actually improve as a person. Even if you don't have anything, I think you can improve as a person. And that is what I'm doing.
I think you just said a very beautiful, improve as a person. And I think that is about upgrading yourself, right? Becoming a better version of yourself. You're not trying to compete with anybody here. So I think those are beautiful thoughts. And once again, Ashima, thanks a lot for coming on the show and sharing your beautiful journey with us. All the best for your future health goals. And I wish and pray you good health and happiness and a very successful future. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishal, and thank you for bearing with my internet today. It's not good, but yeah, thank you so much for inviting me.
We are all aware of work from home internet.
Exactly, exactly. So yeah, it was fun.
Perfect.